Jimmy Stewart was one of our all-time favorites. I mean, the whole staff would raise up with their excitement. Everybody be wonderfully pleased. And what I liked about Jimmy Stewart was the fact that he was a real star. You hear that word bandied around very freely, somebody a star, but he was a movie star. He could play a cowboy. He could play a priest. He could play a gangster. He could play the head of the bank. He could play a bad guy, evil. You know, he could be the romantic lead. He could play any role, and you believed him. And what I loved about him, he also was a military man. He was a pilot. He was a general. I'm a colonel in the Marine Corps, so we had a background. And he wrote poetry, and I write poetry. So I had a nice little connection with him. And, you know, I felt that he felt the same way with me. And he would come on and recite his poem. Now, one night he's on, and he's, excuse me, talking about his dog named Bo. Now, the idea is that Bo has died. But in the poem, Bo jumps up on the bed in his imagination at night, and he reaches out, and he's petting the dog. And we've all had that feeling like that something is there or something. And he wrote this beautiful poem, and he wound up with, "I'll always remember," and that hesitant voice, "a dog named Bo." Well, Carson's in tears, I'm in tears, Stewart's in tears, the audience is in tears. But 6 weeks later, he comes back and he's talking about a lake that his wife wanted to find in Africa. He loved animals also, his wife especially. But they would go over and photograph giraffes and elephants and lions and whatever. So they were on a hunt for a lake. I think it's Lake Barengo. Now, in those days, you couldn't say the word that he actually said. But here's what the poem went, if I can remember. It said, in that hesitant style, which I loved, we searched for Lake Barengo. And when you finally find it, its surface is as smooth as glass. But getting to Lake Barengo is a royal pain. And now, normally in those days, the censor would have pulled that out. That's how strict we were in those days. Now, you hear that word frequently on television. But in those days, you didn't hear it, and you weren't allowed to hear it. But for Jimmy Stewart, they left it in. They made an exception. They said that stays. It had to stay. And, of course, we're dying. So you bring you to tears, bring you to great laughter. But he was a wonderful gentleman. He was a wonderful man. An interesting story about me and Carson in our life. We say goodbye one night on The Tonight Show. And we never made a big thing about it. It was just the show was over. I'll see you tomorrow kind of thing. Off he goes, off I go. The next thing I know, we're standing at the bar in Jimmy Stewart's house celebrating his 80th birthday. We were both invited to the same party. That would happen a lot with us. We'd be invited to the same parties. And he didn't go to many parties, but when he went to them, he went to ones like that. You know, for a Jimmy Stewart, he would go to the party.